Well, of course, when I play my own rock music with my own metal band, Earth and Grave, it's really enjoyable to be able to be part of the songwriting process and improvise. In classical music, you know, you have to play the notes on the page. Mm-hmm. But of course, where our creativity comes in is how we play the notes, because one of the things that distinguishes classical music from most other music is it doesn't have a steady beat. The rhythm kind of ebbs and flows and pushes and pulls, and so how you phrase the music is where so much of the personality comes to life. But one of the things that I find very influential from metal musicians is the way that when a band is on stage, they're not going to kind of play half-heartedly. They're going to play with 150% energy. And within classical music, of course, the emotional palette is much more varied, but I still try to play with 150% to really experience the emotions myself and then reach out to the person in the last row and hopefully get them also caught up in the feelings of the music. Over the years, I've had many opportunities to meet many of my favorite bands, and it's really amazing. All of these guys either were classically trained or listened to classical music. For example, hanging out with Dave Lombardo, the drummer of Slayer, he showed me his iPod, and it's filled with Berlioz and Liszt and Rachmaninoff. Hanging out with Marty Friedman when he was lead guitar mm-hmm. of Megadeth, and he said that he'd been listening lately to the Izai violin sonatas. I'll give you a really good example. I had the great honor of spending some time in Berlin with Uli John Roth, mm-hmm. the original guitarist from the Scorpions, and he said that the Brahms violin concerto was very influential in his guitar solos. And then Eddie Van Halen started copying him, and everybody started copying Van Halen. And now these licks that everybody play come from the Brahms violin concerto.